If you would have told me 5 years ago that Tyler Comas would be an FFA state officer, I would have thought you were downright crazy. Now, I've known Tyler, aka Kangas, for quite some time, dating back several years to when we both rode the number 6 bus, drove by none other than Mrs. Barbline. Tyler was initially extremely shy, only making his voice heard when the lifelong debate of John Deere versus Case IH was held. But this didn't last long. As he became involved with the Atlantic FFA chapter, the timid behaviors vanished. Quickly, his skills flourished as he led our chapter, then our district, and now our state as an officer. I saw his passion for FFA and agriculture develop like nothing I had ever seen before.
When I was in middle school and finally figured out what the FFA really was, I knew I wanted to be a member, but I didn't think I wanted to be involved. It wasn't until 8th grade, when my brother was the chapter president and district vice president, that I figured I should start to get involved. I did a few activities here and there, but didn't get too serious with it. Then came April of my 8th grade year, and Tyler was elected a Southwest State vice president. It was at that moment I knew I should start to get involved. Having state officer brother just felt to me like everyone was going to say, "Okay, now it's your turn." Then Tyler said I should start to get involved because it will be the most fun experience of your 4 years in high school. Tyler was always a push to be involved and be the best in FFA as I could be. I always looked up to him when he was an officer and got super involved, and I knew that I wanted to be doing the same thing he was doing. With that being said, I'm proud to introduce to you my brother.
My neighbor, my friend, and your Southwest District Vice President,
Tyler
Tyler
Comas.
Comas.
There's a party going on around town. It's one rowdy cowboy throwdown here in H-Town, where we're stronger than a hurricane. From miles around, the best of the best come here to put their tough to the test. Give it all for gold or go home broke when they open up that gate. Welcome to the show, welcome to the home of the world's biggest rodeo, where the stars light up the night underneath that Texas sky.
What do you think of when you hear the words leader and legacy? Now, some of you may be thinking of a certain president of the United States, and maybe others are thinking of a civil rights leader. But one thing's for certain, we all have somebody in the back of our head that we think of that has left an impact on one person or an entire group of people. Jackie Robinson, George Washington, and Martin Luther King Jr. Now, all three are known in history classes as people that have led for something that they believed in. Now, we know Jackie Robinson was the first colored athlete to play baseball, and he stood up against numerous sports owners, players, and others that said that he can't do it, but he did. George Washington led his troops and other groups of men across the Delaware River, not knowing what was going to be on the other side. And of course, Martin Luther King Jr. stood and gave the speech that he had a dream. Now, all of these and many, many more have stood up for something they believed in, even when others said that you shouldn't do that. They all believed in a cause, made a decision, and went for it. Now, big or small, all of these decisions were instrumental in what made them famous, and were only brought to light by those who supported and respected what they were doing. Now, I'm sure at the time that all this happened, they didn't care about being talked about in history classes for years to come. But what they did care about was making an impact right then and there and hoping that they could change history forever. I want all of you to close your eyes. Think about a time you made a decision and how it impacted you right then and there. Was it a good moment? Was it a bad moment? No matter what it was, you changed your history forever. The way that you acted when you made that decision, the way you carried it out, it impacted your history. Now, that one decision may not have impacted how people see you, but it impacts how you see yourself. All the decisions that we make in our life are how we are seen by everybody else, good, bad. People see us for decisions we make. Now, I'm not saying that every decision that a person will make will be good for them or everybody else, but it's how you're remembered. Now, when people think of you, Do they think about the good moments that you've had or the bad moments that you've had? Now, I hope that everybody thinks about other people and the good moments that they've had, but you should think about those bad moments. How can we try to minimize those bad moments to the point where nobody thinks about those? They only think about the good things that we've done and the people that we've helped along the way. The only person who controls what we are in our life is ourselves. We're all not going to be the biggest country singer or the president of the United States, but we are going to be something to somebody. We're going to be an idol to somebody. Even though we may not seem like it, that we may have affected somebody with a good decision that we've made in the past. And no matter what we think of, we all have a legacy. Now, some of us may be the scoring record in our high school for points scored in a basketball game. Or some of us, maybe we're the first star finalist in our FFA chapter. But no matter how big or small your accomplishment is, every single one of you has a legacy that you will leave behind for generations and generations. No matter if you think about it or not, every single one of you has a legacy and you've impacted somebody in some way. Now, I want everybody to take off the jacket. Where would you be without your jacket? For me, there's no way I could be standing up here today without this. Without this corduroy jacket. It gave me so much to believe in, and it changed who I am as a person. I went from being a freshman who couldn't hardly stand up and speak in front of an ag class to now giving a speech in front of 5,000 members. This jacket means so much to me, and I'm sure it means something to all of you as well. Now, think about the moments that we've had in this jacket, the good, the bad, and the ugly. The good things that we've done. You know, maybe you are a star finalist. Maybe you won a contest at districts and you're so proud of that. And this jacket helped you get to where you are today. Now, some of us, maybe we're not as involved in our chapter and we don't see the things that we have done in this blue corduroy. But for others like me, this was my saving grace. This got me through high school. This did everything to keep me going. Even when members in my chapter were unsure at times, I led them and I told them that there is going to be a light at the end of the tunnel and good things will happen. This jacket is your legacy. On the back says your chapter, and on the front is your name. When people see that name in that chapter, they all have a connotation. They all associate you with something if they know you, and if they don't, give them something to know you about. Give them your name. Tell them what you do. But let them remember your jacket and your legacy. So I want to ask all of you, how will you be remembered when you're gone? How will your successes and your triumphs be remembered? Will you be remembered as somebody that did something so great in the FFA chapter that they named an award after you? No matter what you do or who you become, you will leave a legacy behind you. Now, I want to ask all of you to think about this question. Iowa FFA, what's your legacy?
Like a rhinestone cowboy.